Well, it is Tuesday, which means, of course, it's time for Tuesdays with Tiphanie. And today's topic is something called Maskne. You know, we're all wearing masks. Are you getting bumps and maybe pimples? Tiphanie is here to talk about some of the ways you can treat this new ailment, something I didn't think we'd be talking about here, Tiphanie, Maskne. Have you dealt with it? I haven't really.
I actually have. I feel like I'm a teenager again. I rarely break out anymore. I actually have some breakouts right here that I'm almost finished with thanks to this stuff that I'm going to show you here. But really, I've had to change up my whole skincare routine from wearing my masks constantly. So I just wanted to share some of the tips that have worked for me, because masks create the perfect breeding ground for bacteria. We're wearing these all day. It's trapping in heat and moisture, so bacteria is thriving. And then along with the friction where it's rubbing our face, it's going to cause breakouts. So right along your chin, maybe on your nose or on your cheeks. So definitely you want to get rid of the perfect breeding ground to make sure you don't break out.
All right. So what can we do to help ourselves here? Because we got to wear them. So I'm guessing the first step would be wear a clean mask, right? That would help?
That is exactly right. I mean, you'd be surprised too how many people are like, oh, I hardly ever wash my mask. We are literally putting back on that dirt and grime right back on your face. So wash your mask is the number one thing, and it helps so much. Or use disposable ones. I don't care. Just you want something clean going on your face.
All right. What about some products?
Yeah, your hygiene, that's huge. So you're going to want to use a gentle cleanser. A lot of people think maybe you would want to go with a major cleanser that dries out your skin, but that's not necessarily the case, because what you're going to want to do is keep that moisture barrier intact that your skin provides protection against the bacteria. So I've shown this before. This is the Epion's the lytic gel cleanser, and it gently removes that dirt and oil from your skin while maintaining the natural moisture that our skin provides. So you don't want to destroy that. But next, that has been my saving grace, and I can't wait to share this with you guys, is the Paula's Choice. It's a salicylic acid, or a BHA. So instead of using physical exfoliants, if we see any roughness, we want to usually go in there and grind it away. Well, not anymore, because the mask causes enough friction. You're going to want to take a liquid exfoliant and get rid of any of the dead skin, oil, and dirt that sits on top of your skin. And this is gentle enough to use every day. So what I do is I cleanse my skin, and then I use a salicylic acid like the Paula's Choice, and I put it in, I use this all over my face. And then a couple times a week, I'll pair the Paula's Choice salicylic acid with a benzoyl peroxide. And I don't just spot treat with this. I'll put it on my entire chin area, because we've gotten rid of the dead skin. Now we want to kill the bacteria, which is exactly what benzoyl peroxide does. Now, if you have deeper blemishes, like one on your chin or something a little more painful, you're going to want to spot treat. So what spot treating does is it just gets in a little deeper. And these products here you can leave on overnight. Now, these little dots here, they're called Peace Out Acne, and it's a polymer that has salicylic acid in it. So it's going to go in once again, and it's going to clean out that pore. So in the morning, you'll be able to see some of the residue and the gunk that it gets out. It's pretty satisfying. Mm. And then a lot of people have already seen this Mario Badescu stuff. It puts the little pink dots all over your face. Now, this has salicylic acid, but it also has some sulfur and zinc oxide, so it's going to draw out those impurities. So in the morning, it will be a little more dry than it was the night before. And use these nightly until you start to see it go away. And also pay attention to how dry your skin is getting. With my last tip, you want to repair that natural moisture barrier that we've just taken away. So you're going to want to use a daytime light gel moisturizer, or a nighttime, I use the triple lipid, which has the ceramides and fatty acids to repair that barrier, to make sure that bacteria doesn't get back in your skin the next morning.
Well, something's working for you, I can see. So thank you for the tip and the advice. And for those of you who want to follow Tiphanie, she's on Shimmer by Shy on Facebook and Instagram, as well as fox2now.com. Thank you for joining us.
Thanks so much, Randy.